In this session, we'll derive the relationship between the electric field intensity and the scalar electric potential V. Okay, so here E is a vector quantity, whereas V is a scalar quantity. Let's consider an electric field E. And earlier we had obtained that the work done in moving a charge Q by dl in the electric field E is given by dw minus Q E dot dl. So this is the work done in moving a charge Q by dl in the electric field E. Okay, so the work done in moving a unit positive charge by dl is given by dv, and this dv is given by minus E dot dl. So this is the work done in moving a unit positive charge by dl in the electric field E. So here we, when we are using rectangular coordinates, in general it's a function of x, y, z. It means that it can vary with respect to all coordinates x, y, and z. So in general it can vary in all directions. So from the knowledge of partial differentiation, we know that dv is given by dou v by dou x ax plus dou v by dou y, so dv is given by dou v by dou x dx, dou v by dou y dy plus dou v by dou z into dz. This can be written as dot product of two vectors. So the two vectors are dou v by dou x ax plus dou v by dou y ay plus dou v by dou z az dot dx ax plus dy ay plus dz az. So this quantity here is known as the gradient of the scalar potential V. So it's indicated as grad V, and this quantity is the differential length dl. So this nothing but dv. So by comparing 2 and 3, okay, so by comparing 2 and 3, we can obtain the relationship between the electric field and the potential. So we can see that here E is given by minus gradient of V. So this is the relationship between the electric field and the potential V. So let us consider one example. So let us say V is equal to 2x plus 4y. So we have to determine E. Okay, so we know that E is equal to minus gradient of V, and here gradient of V in rectangular coordinates is given by dou V by dou x ax plus dou V by dou y ay plus dou V by dou z az. So here we can see that dou v by dou x is given by differentiating this with respect to x, it is 2, and dou v by dou y, so if you differentiate this v with respect to y, it will be 4, and dou v by dou z is 0. So therefore E is equal to minus dou u by dou x is 2 ax plus dou v by dou y is 4 plus 0. Okay, so here we have only the first two terms, so volts per meter. So this is the expression for electric field. So given v, so we can obtain E by taking the gradient of the scalar potential and multiplying by minus 1. That is, it is a negative gradient. Okay, so we have to remember that here it is the electric field is given by, at any point is given by negative gradient of the scalar electric potential. So in rectangular coordinates, the gradient of V is given by dou V by dou x ax plus dou V by dou y ay plus dou V by dou z az. So this is in rectangular coordinates. In cylindrical coordinates, it is given by dou e by dou rho e rho plus one by rho dou v by dou phi a phi plus dou v by dou z a z. So this is in cylindrical coordinates. In spherical coordinates, the gradient of v is given by dou v by dou r ar plus 1 by r dou v by dou theta a theta plus 1 by r sin theta dou v by dou phi a phi. With this, we'll end this session. Thank you.